So in today's video, we'll be learning the drafting of three kind of frocks. First is normal waisted frock, the frock in which the waistline of the garment comes at the normal waistline. There are three kind of frocks we'll be learning: the normal waisted, the low waisted or the drop waisted, and the high waisted or the empire waisted. If you want to know the waistlines in detail, so you can just go through the video which we have created and basic design ideas for the waistline. For this we require the basic bodice block patterns, front and back both, right? So here we have created a block A, B, C, D, where AB is on the fold line. This is on the fold line, and the measurement will be as AB. Let me write it with some dark pencil or pen. AB is equal to 22 inches, that is the full length. I'm making it for the child of 5 years old. So for 5 years old child, the full length is 22 inches, that you can refer from the standard measurement table for kids, right? And in the same way, AC, that means this line, is equal to again 22 inches, that means the all round waist. See, here will be creating the gathers on this particular garment. So we require this 22 inches, that means equal to the all round waist. When it will open, so it will be doubled and you can create the gathers on that. You'll come to know once the things have been cleared. So what we'll do, we'll just take the bodice block of front and we'll trace it here as its center line should touch to the center line, center front, and its shoulder point should touch to line AC, and we'll just trace this. Let me trace this. And this is done. So we have traced the front bodice block at the line AB. Same we'll do with the back bodice block, but before that, what we'll do, we'll take a point C dash as C to C dash is equal to 1 inch, that we are taking for the fold, right? Because at the back there will be the opening, so we are taking it as a, we'll taking a fold here. So we'll drop a perpendicular from this line, which is parallel to line CD. An imaginary line will create like this, right? And what I'll do now, I will just put the back bodice block in such a way so that its center back line should touch to the line, newly created line, that is the perpendicular of C dash, and the shoulder point should touch line to AC, as we have done in case of front bodies. Right. Meanwhile, you subscribe the channel like the video and comment your suggestions and feedbacks in the comment box. This, right? So this is the back. Now what we'll do, we'll just join this to this and this to this. Now start obtaining the points. Suppose this is a point where body's block is touching to this is point E, and here this point is E dash, right? And what we'll do, we'll just join this E to E dash with a straight line. This portion will create the skirt, one for the front and one for the back. We want two cut of this portion, because this is online, one cut of this portion and two cuts of this portion, one cut on fold, right? It will be open, it will be the front, it will be the back, and this is the skirt. Now we'll give the shape to the skirt. What we'll do, from E to E dash, we'll mark a point of 1/2 inch to 1 inch, this, and we'll mark it as F, right? And we'll join this to D. Right, just write it down. E dash to F is equal to 1 inch, right? And now once we have given the shape to this, we'll take a point of D to D dash. It may be 1/4 to 1 inch. D dash is equal to 1/4 or 1/2 inch, sorry. Now we'll take the middle point of this line BD. It was 22 inches, that means at the 11 there will be the midpoint, and we'll mark it F as G, and we'll join this with the help of French curve. Right, this is the grain, this is the grain, and this is the grain. That's it. Now sleeve you can take off your own choice, because sleeves have been cleared in the previous videos. The collar you can take off your own choice, because the collars have been clear in the previous videos. And other things, whatsoever it is required, you can create with your own, because this is the basic pattern of the normal waisted frock, which you can be created, right? So next is number 2 is high waisted frock. In that also, AB is equal to 22 inches, same method. AC is equal to 22 inches, same method. So we have to create one more block with the name of ABCD, and we have to create it. I'll just change the sheet. Now in same way, but we have taken the block ABCD is here, as we described. AB is equal to AB is on fold and is equal to 22 inches, that is the full length of the garment. AC is equal to 22 inches, that means the waist, all round waist, right? Now we have traced the Bode's block as we have done in the normal waisted frog. Now what I'll do, from the point E, we'll take a point F, as E to F is 2 to 3 inches. Here I am taking 3 inches. Depends ki how waist length, where you want the waist line at this time. And in the same way, we'll do with the F dash. Here we can write, for us, E to F, E dash to F dash, 2 to 3 inches. Depends, it's a variable length. Now what we'll do, we'll just draw a line from here to here. Like this. Now this is the Bode's now. This portion is the Bode's now. And this portion is for the skirt now. Right? The skirt length has been increased and the Bode's length has been decreased, so that the waistline of the Bode's will be little bit upper as per the, as from the normal. So same process we'll do. F dash to G, 1 inch, join with the D, 1/2 inch up for the shape, take the middle, and just join this to this. Same, 2 cut, grain, 2 cut, grain, 1 cut. Fine. So this is the high-waisted frog. So if you have learned the normal waisted with the normal method, so high-waisted is very easy for you, because we have to just decrease the body's length of the bodies, and we have to increase the length of the skirt, and it will be created the high-waisted frog. Now we'll come to low-waisted frog. That is the drop waist. Same, AB 22 inches, AC 22 inches. Let us change the draft sheet. The same way as we have done earlier, we have taken a block ABCD. AB is equal to 22 inches, that is the full length of the garment. AC is equal to 22 inches, that is the all-round waist of the measurement of all-round waist, and we have just drawn the front and back bodies as we have done earlier. Now what we'll do, we'll take a point, we'll mark a point as we have done earlier, C dash or everything. I'll mark, this is C dash, this is E, and this is E dash. Now you have an hint, because this is a drop waistline, so it will be a little bit down from the normal waist. So we have to take 2 to 3 inches in this. I am taking 3 inches here. That is F. And same, we have to take F dash, 3 inches, and we'll join these two lines, these two points. I'm joining this like, okay, now this this is the length of the skirt and this is the length of the bodice. But what we have to do with this gap? It is not possible that you can extend this to this and you will extend this to this and you will get the shape of bodice. No, it's not possible, because from here the shape of the body gets wider as compared to the upper portion. So what we'll do, we'll just we'll drop a perpendicular from this point. Let's say this is point G and this is G dash. So we'll drop the perpendicular from point G to line F F dash. Same we'll do here. Now what we'll do, we'll just, and this is the point H and H dash, and we'll just join these two points like this and like this, and then we'll give the shape with the help of French curve. Have you seen? I have not taken it inside. You have to take the shape little bit outside, because otherwise you will decrease the size shape of the garment and it will be tight to the wearer, right? And in the same way, we'll mark a point I, join I to D, mark a point of half inch, and then middle point, and join this with the help of French curve. Grain line to cut, grain line to cut, grain line one cut. One more thing which is very important in this frocks is the belt. I'm just giving you the measurement of belt here. Block is O P Q R. This is actually ties on back, so it may take half of the waist length, half of the round waist to be tied, and then the loosen portion. So it would be OP is equal to 1 inch, that means width of belt. That can be applied on the all three parts, and OQ is equal to approximately 13 to 14 inches. That means 1/4 of the all round waist plus 8 to 10 inches for tying the knot. It all depends how much you want to take, but generally it is 8 to 10 inch is comfortable. You can say knot can be tied if you take it as 8 to 10 inch. And the grain line is this is on fold, and you have to take 2 cut of this, right? So this is all about, not all about, but this is all about today's topic, because 3 more frocks have been left now: the novelty gathered, the layered,
and the yoked. These three frogs will be learning in the next video. Till then, bye-bye and see you again, friends. And thank you very much for loving our channel. Thank you very much for supporting us. And thank you very much for watching this channel. Thank you very much.